In this video, we'll show you how to invite others to work on your website and assign different levels of permission based on what you want them to be able to do. Instead of sharing your username and password, which could be a security risk, you can invite them to create their own user account on your site and become part of your team. This is especially helpful if you are inviting guest authors, working alongside a designer or SEO expert, or just looking to share website tasks with a colleague or collaborator. You stay in control, and everyone else gets the access they need. To view your existing admin accounts and add new team members, visit your site's dashboard and then navigate to Users. Select All Users and then click Add a User top right. The first step is to select the appropriate user role from the role dropdown. Let's take a look at a quick summary of each role, but we will also link to the user role guide below this video for a full explanation. Let's start with administrators. Administrators have full access to your site and settings, and there's usually just one per site. Next, let's discuss the role of an editor. Editors can manage all posts, media, pages, and comments. And when you hover over settings, you will see that editors have restricted access. Thirdly, what about authors? As an author, you don't have access to pages or settings, but you can upload media and create, edit, and publish your own posts. You will also notice you can only view a post written by another author. And lastly, you have the contributor role. Contributors can write and edit their own posts, but they cannot upload media or publish. When they finish a post, they will need to submit it for review. Once you have selected a role for the user, you can invite them by entering their WordPress.com username, if you know it, or enter their email address. You will notice additional email fields will appear automatically as you add more addresses. That means you can invite multiple contributors or multiple editors at the same time. When assigning a user role, you can flag users not part of your organization, such as contractors, freelancers, consultants, or agencies. These users will appear with a contractor label, but it does not change the permissions of the role you've assigned to them. When you are ready, click the Send Invitation button to email the invitation. Before a user accepts the invitation, it will say pending, but when a user is officially added, you will notice their name, username, and role. And when you click on the profile, you can change their role or you can remove them from your site at any time. If you are using WP Admin, you can also find users in the left sidebar and then select All Users. And then click Add User at the top. You will notice it looks a bit different, but in essence, it works the same. At the top, you can add the email or username, assign a role, and then when you click on Add New User, the invitation will be sent. And at the bottom, you will see a list of all the people who have been assigned a role on your site. And if you needed to, you can delete a user role on the right below Actions. If you have hired someone to build or update your website, here are a few things to keep in mind. Never share your username or password, even with a developer, freelancer, or WordPress expert. The safest way to provide access is to add them as users and to add the contractor label. You can also share developer-specific documentation to help them understand key considerations when working on a WordPress.com site. We'll include a link to the developer guide below this video. Once the work is complete, don't forget to remove their access to keep your site secure. And that's how you can safely add and manage users on your WordPress.com site. All the best.